Compaction is the process that makes soil dense. Compaction works very well for sandy material or gravel. It doesn't work very well, unfortunately, for clay soil. If we look at the material that we have here, which is sand, typically that's what we use in the field for construction of embankments, sometimes dams, roads, or buildings. We need to make it dense. We need to make it really hard so that we can easily build on it. We need to make it something like this. It's the same soil that is in the tray, but it's already compacted. You see how hard it is? It's pretty dense. We're going to do compaction test. To do compaction test, we need equipment, which is shown here. We start with the mold. We use this mold to compact soil in it. So we use the sand, we pour it in this mold, and we compact it in three layers by means of this hammer. This is a standard hammer, 2.7 kilograms. We use it to compact soil. We'll show you later how to do it. Once we compact soil in this mold, we would like to know the volume of this material, of this soil. So before we do any test, we need to measure the height and the diameter of the mold. When we put soil, compacted soil in this mold, we also would like to know the mass of the soil. That's why we use scale. We're going to put it on the scale. We're going to measure the mass and record it. Once we complete this test, we're going to obtain some data. We're going to obtain data on the mass of the soil in the mold. We already know the volume of the mold. And we'll also collect some samples for water content. Because in this test, we will add water to soil. And we'll see how water will change the compaction properties of the soil. And now I would like to show you how we analyze the results. To analyze the results, we need to know two parameters. The first is water content that we'll take after the compaction test. And we need to know dry density. That's what we measure during the test. Typically, we start this test with a little bit of water. We would like to start with water content in the range of 5-10%. And we will use this water content to compact soil to some dry density. And after one test, we're going to have some value here. If we know water content and we can measure the dry density, we're going to have one point here. To measure the dry density from this test, we need to know first the density of the soil. So if we know the mass of the soil in the mold, and if we know the volume of the mold, we can calculate the density using this formula, which is density is equal mass divided by volume. But this is not what we need. We need dry density. So dry density is different from density. To get dry density, we need to know the water content of that soil that we compacted in the mold. And dry density is equal to density divided by 1 plus water content. So this density comes from here. And the water content comes from the test when we measure the amount of water in the soil. So typically, we would do about 4 or 5 tests. We'll start with the low values of water content, and then we'll increase the water content. And we will see as we increase water content, the dry density will also increase. At some point, we will notice that the dry density will actually stop increasing and actually will go in the opposite direction and decrease. So we'll need to do 1 or 2 more tests after that to get compaction curve. So your curve should look like this. If we start with low water content, then we'll increase water content. We will also increase the dry density of the soil. Then we'll keep increasing water content, and we're probably going to go over here. Then when we when the water content is higher than its optimum value, you will notice that the dry density will also decrease. So we'll do 1 or 2 more tests to make sure that we're over the peak. And then we will just connect the points and this is the compaction curve we're after. What we need to get from this compaction curve, two parameters. The first one is maximum dry density. This is going to be maximum value. And we need to know the water content that correlates with this maximum dry density value. This is what we call optimum water content. In the industry, when we compact soil in the field, we need to know these two values. We need to know maximum dry density, and we need to know optimum water content. This is the values that we'll give to engineers on site. In real life, it's very difficult to compact soil to its maximum dry density. That's why we say that 95% of the maximum dry density will be allowed in the field. So if this is maximum, we can get about 95% here. So when we do test control in the field, we need to take some samples from the field, and we need to measure the dry density. If the dry density in the range from the maximum dry density to 95% of the maximum dry density, and if the optimum water content, if the water content in the range of optimum water content plus minus 1.5%, in this case, the compaction in the field, it's very good, and we can proceed. If we see that one of these values don't fit in this range, in this case, the compaction is not correct, and we have to redo it in the field. Thank you.